Alright, I'm going to do a quick update on my tank. I haven't done one in a while. Show some progress I have going on here. Alright. Apologize for the lighting. I'm still waiting on my canopy to come in. The main distributor is being a pain in the butt with my fish store. But I guess we'll go over. Here's my pajama cardinal. He seems to be doing pretty good. Still, I got some zoas over here. Here, my green star polyps. This is my pergata coral. It's a type of brain, I guess a lobo. I was told he's great on the sand, so I put him on the sand. A Croatia clam. My toadstool and my bubble coral in the back. I got my green Monty Porus Capricornus in the back. He seems to be doing a lot better. When I got him, he wasn't very colored, so now he's starting to get his green back. I noticed there's a lot of brown on him. I heard it's just because he was a little stressed, but I'm hoping it seems like it's kind of going away. I've been trying to blow it off. Here's my pipe organs. They're out as normal. They're doing pretty good. Let's see what else. Here's my wall hammer. At the moment, I don't think it likes the flow, which is why it's curled up like that, I believe. So I'm probably might move him. We'll see. My wavy hands. Those things are growing like wildfire. I might have to actually frag those. There's my blue hippo. He's not doing too bright either. I'm kind of upset about that. For some reason he's stressed. There are my clowns. Apologize for all the particles in the water. It doesn't have a sump, so I'm trying to use my cancer filter to filter it out, and it doesn't seem like it's doing too well of a job. My yellow tang. It seems like he's getting camera shy right now. What else? Oh, there he goes. Go around here. There's the hippo again. He kind of stays with the cleaner shrimp. I also have a coral beauty, which I think he's hiding over in this area somewhere. It's where he usually likes to hang out. There's my tang. He'll come out here and eventually when I'm not so close to the tank. I think he's freaked out. Let me see where. Oh, there's my coral beauty. You probably can't see him, but he's actually in there. I also got my starfish, my serpent star. Oh, there he is. My serpent star is in there. You won't see him either. He hardly ever comes out, of course. I also have like 25 of the blue red banded snails, 5 of the turbo snails, and a plethora of crabs. Probably about 30 of them, 30 or 40. They seem to be doing the trick. Snails in the back going to work. My main problems I've been having so far with trying to get this tank settled. Well, I mean, it's pretty much is settled. I mean, as you can see, I'm starting to get the bubbles again. My deep sand bed, relatively deep. It's a light, not very deep. It's coming alive. So it's still doing pretty good. Like I said, the main things I've been worrying about is my skimmer. I got an Aquaremora with the 1200 MaxiJet on there. It's just enough for the tank, but I think the bio load in the tank is still too much for it. I'm also using a hang on the back refugium, an ecosystem right here. I'm not really too happy with this system. I had to put a little MaxiJet 400 in there to give that flow that I didn't have before. It was causing my water to go stagnant. There's my heater. And I don't know if you could tell, but I have some cyanobacteria that's growing back there. Yeah, you can probably see it right now. Some cyanobacteria growing back there. Not happy about that either because of lack of flow. Plus, it's a pain in the butt to try to keep my Chaydo and all that stuff from being pushed back from the flow, but you can only do so much, so I'm hoping the water flow will help it out. Otherwise, I'm probably going to resort to getting a hang on the back overflow and get a sump. I don't want to because I'm worried about it flooding and stuff if power were to go out, but I don't think I have a choice if I want something that'll flow better. As soon as I get my 185 gallon up and running and has built-in overflows, I'll probably be a lot happier. But for the time being, I don't think I like the way this is set up. But I'm sure I'll have to just change some things around. It should be good. You see how swelled up my toadstool is. But other than that, that's about it. About my hippo, I really don't know what else to do with him. He seems like he was doing okay. He did have a little bit of ick on him, which was a problem. I could put him in a hospital tank. I can. But I think at this point, I think it would do more harm than good. My cleaner shrimp has been doing a pretty good job of removing all that ick. But in the time being, I'm sure it's probably stressing him out. So I'm kind of lost on what to do other than try to keep feeding him. So yeah. Seems like he's doing okay. Well, no, actually he doesn't. He's been hiding out and stuff, which is not really a good sign at all. So I'm just keeping an eye on him. He feeds. He actually eats. He doesn't eat really much, but he does eat, so that's also a good thing. But he's not eating as much. I mean, my Tang, as you can see, he's pretty fat. So, and I feed him seaweed strips and mysa shrimp. He likes the mysa shrimp. I got some Marina blend with squid and all that stuff, which I know he doesn't eat much of that, but the shrimp and krill and brine and all that stuff they eat, so I don't know. I'm hoping he'll come through. I don't need to be losing any fish. That's not always a good thing. So, but yeah, I just want to show an update of my tank of how the progress is doing. So far, it's okay. I'm waiting on my Chemi Pure Elite. In my canister filter, I put my Chemi Pure, since, again, one of the suppliers is being a complete pain in the butt. I'm waiting for my Chemi Pure Elite. Maybe that'll help get rid of some of the algae that I had on the glass. That was another thing. I had an algae bloom. My phosphates are practically zero, but I think there's a different type of phosphate my test kit is not testing for, which I have a salifer test kit, but I don't think it's detecting whatever else is caused by algae bloom. I have reduced my lighting down to about 9 hours of lighting. It used to be 12, which is what I had on my 10-gallon, but I guess since it's a bigger ecosystem, I had to reduce it down. And then maybe once the bloom gets into control, then I will increase the lighting more. Another thing I did is I decreased the lighting in my refugium. It was on for 17 hours. Now it's down to probably about 10. It does really well. I'm kind of making a little moon cascade in the tank, so kind of like a nighttime effect without the blue lights. So I've done that. I thought, okay, maybe I was overfeeding because I was feeding them 2 or 3 times a day. So I went ahead and fed them once a day, slowly down to 1 a day. So, alright, well, I got company, so I'll sign off here and I'll try to do another update later. Bye.